Hello, it's Shirley and Sir Winston here, and we're ready to hear another installment about the adventures of Joseph in Egypt. So why don't you join us in watching the
The
story?
famine that Joseph had interpreted from the Pharaoh's dreams was widespread. It was felt by Jacob and his remaining 11 sons and the rest of the family in Canaan.
When Jacob heard that there was grain for sale in Egypt, he sent 10 of Joseph's brothers to buy some.
Benjamin, his youngest son, the son of Joseph's mother Rachel, he kept home. Joseph was the governor of Egypt, who sold grain to the foreigners. When his brothers arrived, they bowed down before him, just like the dream that Joseph had. He recognized his brothers, but they did not recognize him. He spoke harshly to them, asking them all sorts of questions, where they were from, and then he said they must be spies coming to see if the land was unprotected. They said they were honest men. They were 12 brothers from one man. The youngest was with their father, and one was no more. He said, "You will be tested. You will not leave this place until your youngest brother comes." And he put them all in custody for 3 days. On the third day, he said, "Let one of the brothers remain in prison while the others can take grain back to your household. But you must bring your youngest brother to me so that I may see that your words are true." The brothers talked among themselves, saying they must be punished for the way they had treated Joseph. And Reuben had said, "Didn't I tell you not to sin against Joseph?" What they did not realize was that Joseph was listening and that he understood every word. Joseph turned away so they would not see his tears, and then turned back to have Simeon taken from them and bound up. Joseph gave orders for their bags to be filled with grain, but that in each man's sack put back the silver that they had paid for the grain and give them provisions for the journey. One of the brothers discovered that his silver was there when he opened his bag to give some grain to his donkey. They were nervous, asking, "What has God done to us?" When they got home, they told their father Jacob about the trip. As they emptied the sacks, they all found their silver. Jacob was very upset. He said, "Joseph is no more, Simeon is no more, and now you want to take Benjamin." Eventually, all the grain they brought got eaten, and they needed some more food, and Jacob said, "Go back and buy us a little more food." His son said to him, "We must take Benjamin." Judah told Jacob to send Benjamin with him, and that he could hold Judah personally responsible. Jacob had to let him go, but told them to take some of the best products of the land as gifts. Some balm, some honey, some spices and myrrh, some pistachio nuts and almonds, and they were to take double the silver, returning what had been in their sacks. When Joseph saw them coming with Benjamin, he said to his steward, "Take them and have them eat dinner with me at noon." The men were frightened. They told Joseph's steward about the money in their sacks. The steward told them not to worry. "Your God, the God of your father, has given you treasure in your sacks, as I had received your silver." Simeon was brought to them. They presented the gifts to Joseph when he arrived, and he asked about their aged father and about the youngest brother.
Joseph
was overcome with emotion and went to his room to weep. He then came back and ordered the food be served. Joseph ate at a table by himself, and the brothers ate by themselves, and the Egyptians ate by themselves, as Egyptians would not eat with Hebrews. The brothers wondered as they sat down in order of their ages. Joseph told his steward to fill each man's sack with as much as they can carry. "Put the silver back in the top, and put my silver cup along with the silver in the youngest sack." The brothers left the next morning, and after a while, Joseph sent out his steward to accuse them of stealing the cup. The brothers protested, saying, "If someone is found to have it, he shall die, and the rest will be your slaves." So the bags were searched from the oldest to the youngest, and they found it in Benjamin's sack. The brothers were in great distress, tearing at their clothes. They loaded their donkeys and returned to the city. They threw themselves on the ground before Joseph. They said, "We are all your slaves." And Joseph told them, "Only the one who was found to have his cup," which meant Benjamin. Judah then spoke up and asked to speak to him and told him that if Benjamin was left there, his father would die, as this is the boy he really loves. "I told my father I would guarantee his safety. Let me remain in his place." Joseph cried out, "Everyone leave my presence." And he told them that he was their brother Joseph. He told them that God had sent him ahead so that he was about to preserve their lives. He said there would be 5 more years of famine, so hurry back, get the father and the rest of the family, and move to Egypt. When Pharaoh heard about it, he told them, "Send carts to help them move, and that they would be given the best land." So they returned to their father and told him about Joseph. So Jacob set off for Egypt, and God told him in a vision that he would make Israel into a great nation there. Jacob and Joseph were so happy to see one another.
Well, that was certainly a story with a lot of twists and turns. I think Joseph was very glad to find out in his testing that his brothers had changed their ways, that even though they knew Benjamin was their father's favorite now, they were very prepared to make sure that Benjamin remained okay. So that's the end of the stories that we're going to do about Joseph. They remained in Egypt for many generations, and there's a whole bunch of different stories that will come out of that. Because remember, they had been promised land in a different place, and they will want to go back to the promised land. So let's have a little prayer together. If you could bow your head and repeat after me. Loving God, thank you for looking after us. Stay with us how you stayed with Joseph. Help keep us and others safe. Help me to be kind to others and look after your world. Amen. And we'll see you next time at Kids Corner.